Look, I've worked my entire life. I've lived an honest life. I've never been accused, sued, of any bad doings.
When the New York Times began digging into the past of 34-year-old George Santos late last year, it triggered a tsunami of stunning revelations, of which there appears to be no end.
I have a college education.
Santos claimed to have attended three colleges, Horace Mann, New York Uni, and also Baruch. He was a star athlete there, apparently.
I actually went to school on a volleyball scholarship.
You did?
I did, yeah.
No, George did not go to college at all.
Look, I sacrificed both my knees and got very nice knee replacements playing volleyball. That's how serious I took the game.
Regarding his work experience, Santos claimed he'd worked for the big financial houses, Goldman Sachs and Citigroup. No, George did not do that either.
We can debate my resume and how I worked with firms such as Goldman
Sachs. Is it debatable or is it just false?
No, it's not false at all. It's debatable.
Regarding his religious background on the campaign trail, Santos claimed to be Jewish. When that was exposed as untrue, he clarified.
I'm Jewish.
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 Have we reached a new low?
And we're all brothers in Christ, I mean.
He also claimed in a Twitter exchange he was part black. Santos claimed his mother's death was caused by 9/11.
My mom was a 9/11 survivor. She was in the South Tower.
We now know that his mother was not in New York. Newly uncovered immigration records show that his mother was actually in Brazil.
As his lies built, so did voter anger.
You have lied for your own gain.
How dare he?
And as Santos took the oath of office, fellow New York Republicans distanced themselves.
Today, I'm calling on George Santos to immediately resign.
We do not want to be represented by a clown.
And Democrats referred him to the House Ethics Committee.
Santos, we have a complaint for you.
George Santos needs to be held accountable for his lies.
In the headwinds, Santos stood defiant.
Congressman Santos, will you resign?
I will not.
Will you step down?
I will not.
Yet the furfies and shonkiness continued to emerge.
You speak like three languages.
Four.
We learned he'd embellished his career earnings.
Because I am a real estate investor. I do invest in real estate.
He'd run a dodgy animal charity that pocketed money raised from GoFundMe.
He said he was going to put the money right into my account. Never happened.
He claimed four co-workers were killed in the Pulse nightclub shooting in Orlando. And videos emerged of him using a different name.
Good evening, everybody. My name's Anthony DeVolder.
George Santos. And he's known as Anthony DeVolder to me. I don't know where George Santos came into the thing, but that's what it says here.
We also learned Santos once owed thousands in unpaid rent, is a wanted criminal for check fraud in Brazil, lied about the details around contracting COVID, and allegedly had a hand in a Ponzi scheme.
And every day we say it can't get any worse.
Do you feel like you're qualified to serve in this Congress right now?
And last Friday, some old friends surfaced to reveal he'd performed as a drag queen in Brazilian beauty pageants. Even though old footage seems compelling, he still denies the claim. But despite it all,
he'll get seated on committee seats.
House Republicans are happy to have his input.
He's got a long way to go to earn trust. But the voters of his district have elected him. He is seated. He is part of the Republican conference.
Yes, I am.
So what's to become of Spurious George?
He's a complete and total fraud.
I'm not a fraud. I'm not a fake. I made some mistakes.
Everyone lies. Apparently we all tell about 1 to 2 lies a day. But when Donald Trump was in office, he told 30,000 lies, about 20 lies a day.
Wow.
Most politicians lie, but what lies are total deal breakers? You would have thought that 9/11, trying to use that in getting elected, would be a no-go.
Well, there's a whole spectrum of lies here, and there's
the drag queen thing's great.
Do what you want. That's not up for kind of even discussion. Like, everyone's got a history, and they do whatever you know at certain stages of your life. I think animal charity fraud and things like that are actual crimes, and that's a problem. But just like the compulsiveness and the pathological nature of this man.
Do you think ultimately this whole scandal with George Santos might be a good thing? Because politics has lying has become the stock in trade, the currency of politics here in Australia, overseas, and it's kind of crept up, right? There's been, you know, one lie after another across the political spectrum, and we accept a lot of it. You know, we just kind of assume that's part of politics. Is this guy the one that makes us say, you know what, actually a bit of truth does matter?
I don't know. Something tells me that Americans are going to keep voting lies into office. They've got a pretty good history of it.